أساس ده آية يقول صاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا. He tells his companion do not be sad, Allah is with us. فأنزل الله سكينته عليه وأيده بجنود لم تروها. الله سبحانه وتعالى brought the سكينة, the peace on them and supported him with soldiers you do not see, جنود لم تروها. And this is what we have to believe. Allah سبحانه وتعالى has a lot of soldiers, we don't have to see them. Everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls. So here he supported him بجنود لم تروها. So one of the things, they wouldn't look under their feet to find the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as they're going, Rasul and Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, sometimes they're in the front. And then he moves to the left of the Rasul. And then to the right, and then behind him. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, settle down, just choose one spot. He says, Ya Rasul Allah, every time I'm on the front of you, I feel somebody might come from the right, so I want to be on your right to protect you. And then I think they're coming from behind, so I keep moving to protect you. For you are a nation, if you die, you are a nation. As for me, it doesn't matter. So he's sacrificing himself, and he's trying to protect the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as we know, Suraq ibn Malik hears that there's two people in a certain spot, traveling, and he figures this is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr. So he goes, takes his sword and his horse because he wants the reward. And as he gets closer to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his horse refused to move forward, subhanallah. If he pushes the horse back, the horse would move back. And again, أَيَدُهُ بِجُنُودٍ لَمْ تَرَوْهَا, soldiers that you do not see. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says this horse was stopped, same with the same thing that stopped the elephant when Abraha wanted to break Al-Kaaba. It's the same thing that stopped the elephants. They wouldn't move forward, but they would move backward. جُنُودٌ لَمْ تَرَوْهَا, soldiers that you do not see. So finally, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Suraqah is trying to go forward and he couldn't. And he says, Ya Rasul Allah, I believe, tell me how could I do, what could I do to help you? Subhanallah. Because he seen his horse wouldn't go forward. His horse wouldn't go closer to Rasul. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells him, send them away from us. Anybody coming this way, tell them we're not here. Subhanallah. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell him, laka suwar Kisra. You will get the bracelet of Kisra, the Persian emperor. Subhanallah. Here, and we look at this toughest moment. This man is coming to kill Rasul, and his sani is in big trouble, but he promises Suraqah the bracelet of Kisra, the emperor, the Persian emperor, which he sees beyond the tough moments. And when we are in tough times, we have to see beyond them and know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support us. Same thing when Al-Madinah was surrounded by Al-Ahzab and they want to destroy the Muslims and kill the Muslims. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells the Muslim, Futhat alaykum Faris, Futhat alaykum Rome, Futhat alaykum Yemen. You will conquer Faris and Rome and Yemen. In these tough moments, he's telling us to look beyond the tough moments and look at the good times. So when we're in despair, rather than think of our problems, look that فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرَى, there will be good times following. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells Suraqah, you will get the bracelet of Kisra. And subhanallah, if we go forward in time 20 years, Suraqah is still alive. And in the time of Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, they conquer Persia and they bring back the wealth of the Kisra, and one of it is the bracelet of Kisra. So Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu asks for Suraqah and gives him the bracelet as the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had promised him. And if we look here, it's simple words, laka suwar Kisra, you will get the bracelet. And Umar looks at the word and fulfills them. SubhanAllah.